Hi, I'm Kale.
Hi, I'm Ashley.
And this is Rope TV.
Welcome to the April edition of Rope TV. This episode is really special because I have a new co-host, Kale. Hi, Kale.
Hi, Ashley. It's so great to be part of the show. Hi, everyone. Thanks so much for joining us on Facebook Live tonight. If you're watching right now, write something in the comments so we know you're watching.
We absolutely love hearing your thoughts. So, don't be shy. The more comments, the better. So, Kale, as you know, this show is all about showcasing the programs at Rope and explaining to you at home how Rope empowers personal development through information, education, and life skills training.
That's right, Ashley. And the Skills for Life program is all about developing skills in everyday life, home, and in some cases, work.
Today is Skills for Life, and we are making jam drop biscuits for Industry & Co. Cafe. I think it's going to be fantastic. Jam drops are always a good recipe to make.
Every week, Skills for Life, we choose a recipe. We've got a book of recipes here, and we do simple recipes that the guys can follow to take down to the cafe to sell them, and today was jam drops.
The process to follow is you put egg, some flour, some flour, egg,
butter,
sugar,
vanilla
essence.
The purpose of this activity is to give the guys confidence and cooking skills, and able to read a recipe, measure and weigh things, and yeah, makes the guys feel good about themselves that it's getting sold down at the cafe. And they ask me every week how it's going and if it's been selling. So yeah, it's good fun. So that seems to be my favourite activity, is cooking with the guys. I also do the cooking program on a Thursday. I also work at Industry & Co. So, and we cook on a Tuesday. So I just like watching the guys develop and grow, being able to read a recipe, being able to remember the recipe, and then just being able to get on and just do it. And I don't even have to tell them what to do, which is nice.
It feels fantastic to come out there and to promote ourselves in the community. It makes us feel valued.
Wow, what a great program. What did you think? Make a comment in the Facebook Live chat. And if you'd like to know more about Skills for Life, just go to the website address on your screen. The link is also in the chat. Now it's over to Ashley, and she's joined by our very special guest.
Thanks, Kale. It's now time to welcome our special guest, Luke Howarth, the federal member for Petrie. Hi, Luke. Welcome to Rope TV.
Thanks, Ashley. It's great to be with you today.
So, Luke, what inspired you to become a politician?
Well, when I was younger, my when I was 14 years of age, my mum and dad were handing out for a local politician. I think it was down in Aspley. I think they were doing letterbox drops. And I asked dad and mum, why are you doing this? And they said, oh, he's a good person and wants to help the community. And so that sort of got me interested as a teenager in politics. But actually, I really enjoy meeting people, and it's very diverse. Representing an electorate and the amount of people you meet. So I love people, and being a politician is a great job to be in if you enjoy meeting people.
Exactly. Was this something that you always wanted to do?
Yeah, from when I was about 14, I wanted to do it, but it wasn't the first thing I wanted to do. I also wanted to be a sales executive, and I had a job as a sales executive with Sony. And I wanted to run my own business, and I had my own business before coming into Parliament, so I'd always worked in the private sector. But then, yes, I did have a goal to be a politician, and I really enjoy the job. I enjoy meeting people. You try to please as many people as you can. You can't please everyone, but it's a job that I really enjoy.
Yeah, that's just really, really good. What did you do before you became the federal member for Petrie?
So the business I used to run was a family-owned pest control business. So what we used to do was protect people's homes against termites, and also we used to look after commercial businesses and residents for general pest control. So it was a pretty cool job. We had 20 staff. We ran our own business. It was called Sandgate Pest Control. Some of your viewers may have used the company. We don't own the business anymore. But it was a great business, and once again, dealing with lots of people and different customers. So yeah, good job.
Sounds like a great job. What is your portfolio, and what does that entail?
Yeah, that's a good question, Ashley. So I'm the federal member for Petrie here in Moreton Bay in North Brisbane. But I have a role in the Australian government as Assistant Minister for Youth and Employment Services. And so youth is 15 to 25 year olds. You might fall into that bracket, but 15 to 25 year olds that make up 15% of the Australian population, and listening to what's important to them around employment and education and the environment and mental health. And then I also do employment services, helping people of all ages find work, find employment, and find a career that they love. And so that's something I really enjoy too, having run a business previously and used to hiring people.
So Luke, what do you think is the most important part of being a politician, and why?
Well, I think to be a good politician, you have to be a good listener, and you have to be engaging with people. So you've got to be out and about talking to local people through all ages, and understanding what is important to them. So you can't really represent an area if you're not listening and talking to people and what issues are important to them. So it's quite diverse. You can be in a preschool one day and an aged care facility the next, or talking to young people like yourself, or you know, middle-aged people like me. So it sort of varies every day, different people you meet, but you have to listen, and then you have to take that on board and try to get action for people.
So this is your second appearance on Rope TV. Do you think having a show like this is a good for the disability sector, and why do you think it's important?
Well, I think it's important because people with disability are important people in our community, and we need to ensure that people with disability are given all the opportunities that is available in the employment sector. You're doing a great job as host of Rope TV today. Good questioning, good communication. And we need to make sure that employers, not just in the government sector, but in the private sector as well, understand everything that people with disability can offer. So I think Rope TV is very essential, and it's a great opportunity for you to practice and hone your skills as well. You might be able to get a gig on a local radio station, or hosting some program on a national broadcaster. those opportunities are there, and with the unemployment rate at the moment at 4%, we need to get everyone into the workforce. That could be people that are on a disability pension, for example, or people that are on Job Seeker. At the moment, there's more jobs than what people are applying for, so everyone needs to apply and be given an opportunity.
Yeah, that's just wonderful. Luke, what has been your greatest achievement as a politician so far?
Well, look, I think I'll sort of leave it to others to judge about what I've done, but I think for me personally, the fact just being elected initially as the federal member for Petrie and then being re-elected twice, that has been a great achievement, you know, because you want people to see, have faith in you and believe in what you're doing. And so for me, I never take it for granted. I just continue to put out there to people every day and listen to them and try to deliver. So I can't think of one particular thing that I've done that I want to highlight, other than to say it's a great privilege to be the federal member. It's a great privilege to be an assistant minister in the Australian government. And if I just keep focused on people, then I think I'll do okay.
So thank you so much for being on Rope TV today. I appreciate your wonderful time to join us for today on Rope TV.
Yeah. No, well, thank you, Ashley, for what you're doing, and well done to you. And I look forward to coming back again. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Luke.
No worries. Bye-bye.
What did you think of Ashley's chat with Luke? Make sure you write your comments below because we love hearing from you. Okay, it's time to talk about another program at Rope called In-Home Support. Michael receives 24/7 in-home support. Let's see how it works.
Michael's my big brother. So he's lived at this address since 1969. Describe Michael. I've known Michael about 15 years, and when I first met Michael, well, maybe it might be a little bit longer than that, he could actually do a little bit of walking.
I've been with Michael for 23 years. I came to the family in 1999.
Michael is 61. Yeah, 61. He has been disabled since birth.
I've known Michael since I was in my late 20s. Michael and I have virtually grown together, you know. I see him. I see him as not a friend, but a brother to me, because we've been through so much together, you know.
Well, Michael's a really sociable person. He's pretty well known around Redcliffe, and he loves his carers.
He loves, you know, going for picnics, mm-hmm. long drives and going for picnics.
Even though he's been through a lot and he's in a lot of pain, even though he has pain patches to help reduce the pain, he's happy. You know, he's happy in himself. He loves his staff team. But where Rope really did kick in and help out was in May last year, when my 81-year-old mother, she had a fall, she broke a collarbone, and she was no longer able to live independently in this house. And so she could no longer look after Michael. The doctors advised her that she couldn't look after Michael anymore, and so she moved into a retirement village where she's cared for, and Michael visits her every week and he looks forward to that. Rope took over and became a 24/7 supporting Michael overnight. Michael ended up getting quite sick and was in hospital, and the staff continued to support him at the hospital because nurses couldn't understand him. Michael wasn't taking his medication from the nurses.
think it's good if other families can see how situations evolve and see that there can be a solution, because we were quite overwhelmed about 12 months ago when Mum was in hospital and we had Michael. Rope didn't look after Michael. They did help, and Michael's been in hospital seriously ill too. Less than 12 months ago, he was actually in palliative care, and the Rope workers came and spent time with Michael and spoke for him in the hospital.
So yeah, it was a little bit sad, and then the hospital needed the bed, so they discharged him and we got all the medication and set up here, and Michael's just thrived. He's happy, laughing, and so yeah, he has his few favourites, but I think he likes all of us.
He loves to go for a drive. Pretty good life, mm-hmm. And that's because Rope, I don't think individual families can support for a lifetime someone who's got major disabilities, and I think it's been good for Michael to have Rope workers work with him. He's been wonderfully looked after by my mother, but at 81 she couldn't be able to look after Michael around the clock.
That brings us to the end of this episode. What did you think, Kale?
I loved it, but I'd also like to know what everyone at home thinks. Make sure you put your comments below and don't forget to like and share this video.
You can also subscribe to Rope TV on YouTube. That way, you'll never miss an episode.
See you next time.